We're joined by Meatloaf. Meatloaf, thanks very much. Welcome to New Zealand again, and thanks for joining us. And you'll be co-hosting the show, and I'll be talking to you later.
Welcome to New Zealand.
That's me
again.
Well, you've been here before, haven't you?
I have.
That's me saying that to
three times. Three times I've been here.
When were you first here?
I was. What did you say, Marcus? I need an interpreter with you.
Okay. I tend to mumble a bit.
No kidding. I didn't know that about you, Marcus.
And that makes people listen a bit harder, and it goes in their head clearer.
That's
okay.
Right. When was
that's
I first here? Is what
thought.
You asked me, right?
Yeah.
Around about 1989.
Cool.
I was here with the Pepsi challenge, whatever that was.
I don't know what that was.
I don't know what it was either.
I wasn't on that junket circuit then. I wasn't going to the rich and famous dudes like I do now.
Really? You go to those now?
Yeah, some of them. Well,
which ones you go to?
Oh, that would be. Oh, I just sort of stuff.
Oh,
you know,
come on, Marcus. I ask you a legitimate question.
Well, I normally don't go to them because I normally feel a bit funny about all that sort of celebrity carry on.
Oh, I see.
Just,
okay.
I might just lurk in the background and go down towards the end when it's just about finished and see what's happening. But I'm going to have to go to Kim.
Right.
We'll be back with you
well,
with
let's go to Kim.
Yeah, over to you, Kim.
Thank you, Marcus.
And me.
And me, yep. Yeah.
You're welcome, Kim.
Good. Well, he's arrogant, obnoxious, rude, neither of those
Marcus,
two, of course.
No.
Smokes, drinks, and swears a lot more than you can get away with on the telly. Sound attractive? Well, unfortunately, if you live in Wellington, he's hard to avoid. He's Derek Archer, resident rude person on the capital's Pirate FM. And reporter Lotta McVeigh went to find out what's got this Kiwi Howard Stern's knickers in such a twist.
There's Joan's armour plating. In fact, her armour plating is so good. I mean, she's a tough lady. In fact, from what I understand, she rolls her own tampons. Didn't I just say what I think I just said? I did, didn't I?
Yes, he did. This is Derek Archer, radio DJ and professional big mouth, the jock who loves to shock.
Doing it with Chris Rea, forming a mutual band at the moment with Dire Straits. It's going to be called Diarrhea. Now, there's a band called the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. The song was written actually by Mike Nesmith, and his great claim to fame is his mother created Twink. You know Twink? The shit that dumb computer people use on their screens?
I never, ever wanted to be in radio. I never, ever wanted to go on air as a DJ. It was probably the weirdest thing in my whole life. As I was driving down Wakefield Street in Wellington, and I was going, oh God, these radio stations are boring. And I hit the button and I got the concert program. And it was a guy, I think it was Philip Burton or somebody. I think he's up there with Maurice Williamson's office. And it was deregulation of broadcasting in New Zealand. And I went, yeah, right. Now tell me how that works.
He found out and became the first holder of a private radio license in New Zealand. Pirate FM's known for being the fastest request station in the city and the most obnoxious.
That's why it says shock rock radio. It's, you treat them like shit and what do? Come back for more. Every day and every way they come back for more because they appreciate the fact that you actually do care about what's going down their ears. This is a radio station from hell. You're the pirate. Go and make a nuisance of yourself somewhere else. Has anybody ever pointed out to you you got bad attitude? Did anybody point out to you you're an idiot? Who do you have to know here to get a drink? On the Pirate 96.3. We've got some grey clouds out there, but then again, at least they're not mushroom clouds.
But it wasn't nuclear bombs that got Derek in the end. This weekend, his station was destroyed by fire.
I will be 90% sure this was arson.
But quite why someone would burn Pirate down is beyond Derek.
We have no enemies. Pirate FM really only makes friends, and it's a community-based station.
He's now back on air with a makeshift sound desk. It won't be long before things are back to normal.
Can you get me out of this radio station? I'm going mad here.
It seems to me in some ways, Meat, that the CD survived the fire. Did you notice that?
Yeah, I did. I did notice that. No, vinyl would have melted right away,
yeah.
Without a doubt. Vinyl would have just gone into a big
CDs,
heap of melt.
It's all like.
You think it's still played?
I think he might have taken them to his new studio, ironed them off, and I think he was still playing those.
Now, was he weird, or was that just me?
He seemed to have a certain attitude. I mean, I didn't go there and do the story. Young Lotta from Wellington did the story. Right. I don't know what the vibe reading was from the guy.
Now, my other question to you is, and
you
to Kim as well.
One?
No, I don't want you to answer that one.
You well, why did you
did.
Ask it?
Well, you did answer that.
Okay, well, I was going to go on with more.
Oh, well, yeah. Go ahead then. No. Don't.
I've lost the plot.
You did? Do they know who Howard Stern is here in this country?
Yeah, I think people do, yeah.
Yeah? You think, should we have a call-in vote now and see how many people actually know about Howard Stern?
Yeah, and then you'd have to face the people on the switchboard on the way out and they get hundreds of phone calls, you see. But we can have a phone-in competition if you want. Is he a good bloke, Howard Stern? He's a radio DJ in America, right?
Well, let me just tell you that. Let me just tell you this.
That's right.
Yeah, let me just tell you this.
He doesn't talk about you.
Not in the book, but he likes me, yeah. Let me just tell you this. He's been fined $8 million by the FCC in America over the last 4.5 years.
For profanity? I'm spitting.
Just
for profanity?
Not necessarily for profanity, but just in for being general unruly.
Did you go on his show?
I have been on his show, yes.
Did he treat you well?
Yeah, oh, he likes me a lot, yeah. But he always wants to call my wife and find out what kind of lover I am. But we know that already. He doesn't need to go on. He knows I'm a sex god.
We'll come back to that. We'll come back to sex god meatloaf. Back to you, Kim, or something. Okay. Oh, no, that's me. We can say that.
That's right. Okay. And now, the latest showbiz carry on. Here is Paparazzi. Yes.
Hollywood romance shock. Confirmed Bachelor and Palmolive Gold user Keanu Reeves says he won't be getting married. Excuse us if we don't faint, Whiffy Boy, but last we heard, the sweaty action man was being romantically linked to boys rather than girls anyway. Keanu now says he shouldn't have to defend his heterosexuality just because he keeps his private life quiet. But then he says the only woman he's been seeing lately is his sister. We're not too fussed either way, love, but make up your mind, eh? Well, just because Keanu hasn't got the love bug doesn't mean Pam and Tommy can't thrash those wedding vows. They've got wed twice already, and now the bonk crazy pair just want to do it again and again and again. Silicon outed Pam says she wants to get married everywhere and hopes eventually that her mum will come and see one. Tommy's family's missed out on the heartwarming special occasion so far too, but as Pam says, when it's a last minute thing, it's just kind of whoever's there is there. Well, not going anywhere anytime soon is that rabid rapper Snoop Doggy Dogg. He's been put on an electronic leash and $1.5 million bail while he lies down, rolls over and generally stays put while waiting for his October 23rd murder trial date. He was involved in a drive-by shooting in 1993. And the latest Stallone shoot fest, Assassins, has premiered in London with a star-studded cattle call that even brought out that shy and retiring Madonna. She's been laying down her golden vocals to a new Evita soundtrack. Yeah, sorry folks, that means she'll be trying acting again when she stars as Eva Perón in the upcoming movie. Co-starring is the new Mr. Griffith, Antonia Banderas.
Just like a family movie for you with that crowd there,
yeah,
mate.
That was funny. The shy and retiring Madonna. How about Pamela Anderson?
We love her down here.
You do?
Yeah.
Is that lack of clothing or what?
I don't know. Just her sheer sense of individuality and her ability to do what she wants, to marry the rough rocker and that sort of carry on, you know. I don't know.
Okay, Marcus. Listen, right after the break, we're going to find out what infamous accused murderer is still the holder of a world record, and I'm going to chat with Marcus about my new album, New Zealand, and a lot more, Marcus.
TV presenter and junior medico Hinemoa Holmes is 30 today. On this day in 1949, New Zealand's first commercial recording, Karaitiana's Blue Smoke, was released. And Stevie Ray Vaughan would have been 41 today.
Hey, welcome back here with Meat Night. Tonight we're joined by the man who has sold more records than he's had hot dinners, although he's named after a dish that's usually served cold. It all started with a Bat Outta Hell album in 1977, which is still the longest charting record in history, selling 24 million copies. Six noughts. Meat arrived in New Zealand today. It's his new album. Welcome to the neighborhood. It's the record stores. Meat, thanks for coming along.
Normally served cold?
Meatloaf.
It is?
Yeah. Did you not know that? Here it is.
Oh, it is?
Always. A 21st, 20 big occasion, you get the meatloaf, bottles of beer,
on
and Pavlova.
What occasion? What occasion?
A 21st. That's like a coming of age ritual
in
New
Zealand. 2 years ago when we were on the radio, I'm absolutely convinced that we were talking about this during the commercial break, and I finally get an opportunity to sit behind a news desk, wear my glasses, and look.
You look regal. Look, yeah, apart. I said that, yeah.
But anyway, back to what I was talking about. You didn't mumble 2 years ago, Marcus.
I don't think I mumble now.
You don't?
Your ears have slowed down.
So far, Marcus.
Between and there, it's your ears.
No, so far, Marcus, you've said to me about five things that I've had to go, what? And my wife would be here going, no, you don't say what, you say excuse me.
Mate, as you get older in life, things slow down and you're not hearing me as quick or as clearly.
I see. So you're telling me that I'm old now, Marcus.
I'm not telling you you're old, but you're telling me a mumbler and I'm taking some sort of offense to it. Now, your vocal range. I read somewhere you've got the largest vocal range of any known musical performer. Like a Helgen tenor or something.
Where did you read this piece of information? I'm an owl, okay?
In the New Zealand Herald.
Well, it just goes to show you can't believe everything you read.
In the New Zealand.
You knew that.
Have you got a very long vocal range?
Like there's some long? You mean wide? Whatever it is.
I mean, spanning.
No, it's okay. It's not. It's not extraordinary. It's average, I think.
But are there special parts in opera that only you can sing?
Well, Helden tenor. No, what it really means, what a Helden tenor means, is that you sing higher than it sounds.
Just give me an example.
Oh, shut up, Marcus.
Give me an example.
Day I will make it come again.
Thank you.
Now, those were very high notes, but it just didn't sound that way.
So they're very high, but they seem low.
That's right, and loud.
So it's a dramatic effect.
That's right. So there you are. Now, see, I sing with Pavarotti.
Really?
You know what he did to me?
What?
Oh, listen, this guy's a little weasel. Well, he's a big weasel, actually.
Pavarotti's a weasel?
Tell me. He's a nice guy, but I think he's a little paranoid, you know?
Because of your talent?
No, I think he's paranoid of anyone's talent. He did this to me. He said to me, he wanted me to sing a song with him, right?
Yeah. Like, but he asked you. He phoned up and said, mate, come and sing with me.
Well, he kept calling me, but see, I'm kind of weird. Like if a celebrity calls me, I get really nervous and I don't know what to say to them. And I panic somebody will call me and my wife will say, blah, 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 is on the phone. And I'll go, I can't talk to him. You talk to him. And so Pavarotti called me up on the phone.
At home.
He called me. I answer the phone and I hear this voice go, in Italian, is Meatloaf there? And I go, who's calling? And he said, Luciano Pavarotti. And I went, no, I'm not here. I said, no, he's not here. He's at this number. And I hung up. So I go to the other number and they call me. And eventually I was forced to talk to him. And I was really nervous. So then when I got to him, I finally said, okay. He said, sing this song, come back to Sorrento. I said, okay. So we started searching for versions. We found a version by Dean Martin that was all, you know, like, I couldn't understand what he was saying. He's a mumbler like you are.
Oh, Pavarotti's a mumbler.
No, not Pavarotti, Dean Martin.
Dean Martin.
And so then finally what we come to the conclusion, okay, that I'm going to do come back to Sorrento with Pavarotti. So I learn it in one key, and I get there, and I'm very loud. And so I sing like two bars of this song. And all of a sudden, they all start talking in Italian. Blah, 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 blah. You know, forget about it, Angelo. Forget about it. And
it's so then story. For the. Long story.
So it is a long story.
It's longer than four.
That's right, it is. But that's okay. It's a good story.
Okay.
So anyway, the bottom line is he lowers the key for me and keeps the same key for him.
Is that right?
Yeah, so that he thought he was going to be louder than me.
So that's
I was louder than him in the lower key. There you go.
So you did him.
Yeah, but I can't. I mean, why should he care? I mean, he's an incredible singer. I didn't say I was a better singer. I just was as loud. So that's the interview, and you know what?
Now tonight's information off-ramp.
That's right. The information off-ramp. Here we go. Well, guess who holds the world's record for the 4x100-yard relay? Orenthal James Simpson. Yes, the very same O.J. who's cooling his heels at the moment waiting for the verdict. The record still stands as a distance isn't run anymore, but O.J. was a bat out of hell in his day. holding the relay record on three different occasions.
Everyone that comes on is better than me. Are we a sport mad nation? Of course we bloody are. A new hillside subdivision in Christchurch has been named after New Zealand America's cup skipper. Now, it's not Coots Court or Blake's backyard, but for a few thousand you can move into Eggnot Heights, named after Christchurch only as the Eggnot, who skippered for the other side in the Defender Series. And if you're lucky, you might just spare an address in Defender or Challenger Lane. Leslie named the streets herself.
You know what? Look at this. Here's some new Coke bottles that look very much like the old ones. Yes, but in response to customers' demand, Coke has released the original shape.
It's re-released.
Yeah, okay, they re-released it. Re-released the original shape. You get a bit less than you than what? Go ahead, you finish it now.
You get a bit less than the can though, and if you haven't got a bottle opener, you're stuffed.
Although
you shouldn't use your teeth.
When I was younger, I used my teeth. I never saw though written that way. It totally confused me that though.
Don't do
there.
That. But it's good in the bottles, eh?
And it's great. That's the best way to have Coke is in a bottle.
Excellent.
That's it. That's it. We did that well, Marcus.
We're a duo, eh?
That's right. That's
right. I'll be packing my bags and coming on the road.
That's right.
And I won't even go home.
Should we just switch? And,
yeah.
Can I have that little thing you got in your ear?
I don't
have one of those. They didn't give me one of those.
If you really want it.
Oh, no, I don't. Oh, is it Kim's turn yet?
That's tonight's information off-ramp. Here's Kimmy with tomorrow's weather.
Oh, I can't wait. I'm going to be here tomorrow.
Thank you, Marcus. Thank you, mate. That's been so much fun. Great. But just when you thought the weather was on the up, the north's going to be coated in rain as a strong nor'easter picks up. Place to be is Gisborne. It'll be 20 and should be shower-free. And brollies and coats needed in the south too, with widespread rain from top to bottom. Blenheim looks good on 18, but will cop a drop or two by evening.
No, there's not much for the south on, was there? Hey, on tomorrow's show, we unmask this mysterious man, this mysterious nightclub sensation, who goes by the name of Killer Ray.
Hi-ho, Silver! Away!
He's good, eh?
He is good.
Killer Ray.
He's very good.
He's a New Zealand jazz musician.
That's right. Yeah. So anyway. I know we didn't talk about the new album at all.
But we're going to play a bit of it now.
We are.
And
from Welcome to the Neighborhood.
Yep.
Welcome to the Neighborhood. I'd lie for you and that's the truth.
And you're going to come back and play it? I mean, you're going to come back and tour?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
You're not just here talking.
No, I'm not just here talking. We're back and playing sooner than you can say Bob White.
Who's he?
It's a bird.
Oh, okay. We've got to go.
Let's hear it.
Here's a
good night.
Good night. Bye-bye. Thanks very much.